गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड ओम मीटर्स मैथड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ मेजरमेंट ऑफ लो रेजिस्टेंस. नाउ कमिंग टू द मेजरमेंट ऑफ मीडियम रेजिस्टेंसेस, वी हैव फोर मैथड्स: एमीटर, वोल्टमीटर मैथड, सब्स्टिट्यूशन मैथड, व्हीटस्टोन ब्रिज मैथड, कैरी फॉस्टर ब्रिज मैथड. नाउ विल स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट टॉपिक एज अ एमीटर वोल्टमीटर मैथड फॉर मेजरमेंट ऑफ मीडियम रेजिस्टेंसेस. We have already discussed this method in a measurement of low resistance, but there we have studied about like small part of it. Here we'll discuss this in more brief. Now coming to the method, ammeter voltmeter method. So this method is very popular, and since the instrument required for this test is usually available in the laboratory, we are requiring only voltmeter and ammeter for the test. This is the simplest process of all the method. So the resistance that is to be measured will be equals to voltmeter reading divided by ammeter's reading. We have discussed this already. Now coming to the two circuits for this method. So here are the two circuits, like two connections of voltmeter and ammeter. For in first case we have taken voltmeter, then ammeter, then our resistance that is to be measured. In second case we have taken first ammeter connection, then we have taken a voltmeter connection in a shunt with our measured resistance. There are two kinds of error in both of the circuit, so we'll discuss each circuit and the error associated with it. So in first case we have a voltmeter there, then an ammeter, and then resistance. So here the error is in the voltmeter actually, because this voltmeter will read the voltage drop across this resistance and this ammeter. And in the second case there is a error in this ammeter, because the total current will be going through this, so this will measure the current in the unknown resistance R, and it will also measure the current flowing in this voltmeter. So this will give the summation of IR plus IV. Now coming to the first circuit, the measured value of the resistance Rm would be equals to the true value R. We are having Rm as a measured value and R is a true value. And if the ammeter resistance is zero and voltmeter resistance is infinity, so that the condition in the circuit are not disturbed. This is ideal condition where we need the ammeter resistance to be zero and the voltmeter resistance to be infinite. But it's not in a practical case. So voltmeter resistance cannot be go to infinity. So these two connections will give us inaccurate result. Now considering the first circuit, in this circuit the ammeter will measure the true current and voltmeter will measure the voltage drop across both the elements, like ammeter and our unknown resistance. So basically we have discussed that voltmeter will give the inaccurate result. Now coming to the description of first circuit. The voltmeter indicates the sum of the voltage across the ammeter and the measured resistance. Let RA be the resistance of an ammeter, so the voltage across the ammeter will be VA, that is IRA. The measured value of resistance will be Rm1. In first case we will be taking the measured value of resistance as Rm1, which is equals to V by I, and here V is a reading of a voltmeter, so this will be equals to VR plus VA divided by I. So the total measured value of a resistance will be R plus RA, that is RA is a resistance of a ammeter. Now coming to the true value of resistance, that will be equals to R is equals to Rm1 minus Ra. Now taking Rm1 as a common, we are having R is equals to Rm1 in bracket 1 minus Ra by Rm1. So from this expression we can say that the measured value of resistance is higher than the true value. It is clear from the above that the true value is equals to measured value only if the resistance of ammeter will be turns to be zero. Then only the Ra will be equals to Rm1. So the relative error in this method will be Er is equals to Rm1 minus actual resistance R divided by the actual resistance. Here this Rm1 minus R is equals to Ra. So the relative error will be equals to Ra by R. It can be zero if the resistance of ammeter will be zero. It is clear from the equation this that the error in measurement would be small if the value of resistance under the measurement is large as compared to the internal resistance of the ammeter. So this basically this circuit, first one, it should be used for measuring the high resistance values. Okay. Now considering the second circuit where we are having this ammeter first then the voltmeter. So this ammeter is carrying the total current and the voltmeter is having its true value. Now coming to the second circuit and its description, we are having in this circuit we have voltmeter that measures the true value of the voltage and ammeter measures the sum of the current in the total circuit. Let RV be the resistance of a voltmeter. So the current flowing in the voltmeter will be IV is equals to V by RV. Here it's RV. IV is equals to V by RV. So the measured value of resistance will be Rm2 in our second case will be equals to V by I. V is the reading of a voltmeter, that is a true value, and I will be the IR plus IV. So putting the values of IR and IV, we are having this expression. Cancelling out the V in from above and denominator, we are having Rm2 is equals to R divided by 1 plus R by RV. So the true value of resistance from this equation 3.17, if we cross multiply this 1 plus R by RV to this and taking the R common, and we will get the R is equals to Rm2 multiply by RV divided by RV minus Rm2. So here this is not the equivalent of this, like this is not true. We are having this equation expression from this expression Rm2 is equals to R divided by 1 plus R divided by RV. So the true value of resistance will be R is equals to Rm2 in bracket 1 divided by 1 minus Rm2 by RV. So from this equation 3.18, it is clear that the true value of resistance is equals to the measured value only if the resistance of a voltmeter is very large as compared to our resistance under the test. So this term gets approximately negligible. Now coming to the further explanation. If our RV is very very greater than our measured resistance, then only Rm2 divided by RV will be very small. So from the binomial This comes directly from the binomial theorem. If the this term in denominator is negative and if is very small, we can take this expression as 1 plus Rm2 with the sign change, 1 plus Rm2 divided by RV. So the method value, so the measured value of this resistance is smaller than the true value in this case. So coming to the relative error, Er will be equals to Rm2 minus actual value, that is R, divided by R. So by putting the value of r from our equation, this expression where r is equal to rm2 rv divided by rv minus rm2, if we put the value of r in the relative error, we will be getting our relative error is equals to rm2 square divided by rvr. The value of rm2 is approximately equals to r, so our relative error comes to be negative of r by rv. So from this equation 3.21, the error in the measurement would be, it is clear that the error in the measurement would be small if the value of resistance under the test is this one, under the measurement is very small as compared to the resistance of a voltmeter. So that only our relative error will be very small. So basically this second circuit will be used where the resistance under the measurement is very low. Now furthering explaining the method, we have discussed two types of circuit in this method. Basically our accuracy is dependent upon our ammeter and voltmeter. The accuracy is being limited by the accuracy of ammeter and a voltmeter used even if the corrections are made for the voltage drop across the ammeter for the correction in our circuit 1 and shunting effect of a voltmeter for a connection 2. If the instrument are of 0.5 accuracy and read near the full scale, the instrumental error in the result may be anything from 0 to 1%, and if the reading will be half scale, the percentage error may be twice as great and for low readings we are having a considerably high error. With less accurate instrument, the possible error of course is increased. It is difficult to obtain the accuracy much better than 1% in a resistance value under usual condition, and the error sometimes may be considerably high. So the method is useful in some laboratory work in which high accuracy is not required. The suitability of a particular method for resistance measurement depends upon the relative values of resistance under the measurement and the resistance of a meters like voltmeter or ammeters. The division point between the two methods is at the resistance for which the relative errors given by two methods are equal. So if we are taking the relative errors of both the cases are equal, we are having this RA divided by R is equals to R by RV. So the true value of resistance will be R is equals to under root of RA multiplied by RV. So from this expression we can say that if the resistance, the true value of resistance under the test have a value greater than this under root of RARV, then the circuit first will be used where we have error in a voltmeter, and if the resistance is low, true value of resistance is low compared to this one, we are going to use the circuit second in which the true value of voltmeter is there and ammeter measures the total current. So here in this ammeter voltmeter method, we have discussed two types of connection of voltmeter and ammeter, and we have seen the errors in that. In next lecture we will be going to study substitution method as a part of measurement of medium resistance. Here I'm ending this lecture. For any query related to this topic, you can write me. The notes will be provided to our college website. Till then, continue your lectures. Stay healthy, stay safe.